Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. As we finish up our focus on faith today, I just realized that, like, my faith has grown over the summer as well. And I'm sure yours has too. By now, you probably already know what faith means, but let's go over it one more time. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. We've seen how it takes real focus to have faith in what we can't see. We can have faith in God because we can see how good God is. We can take a closer look and see how God's worked in our lives and in the lives of people we know. All year long, we've been going through the Bible and making our way to the end. Well, today, guess what? We're at the last book of the Bible. It's in a book called Apocalypse. Not really. The book is called Revelation. Revelation was written by the Apostle John. When John wrote it, he was very old. As a matter of fact, he was the last disciple living. And he was living on an island called Patmos. And he was a prisoner. On Patmos, John had to go into the mines and dig out salt for the people to use. And there was no way off this island. John had been taken there because he wouldn't stop telling people about Jesus. And again, John was very old. He outlived everyone. And he, at the end of his life, he was living with criminals. He had watched as the early church grew and how the story of Jesus spread. But John had also seen terrible things happen to those who believed in Jesus. And many of them had even died for talking to others about what they believed. Still more people than ever were following Jesus. God's story was traveling from one end of the world to the complete other side of the world. Just as Jesus said it would. One day, John heard a loud voice, like a trumpet. The voice told him to write down what he was about to see. John turned around to see who was speaking, and it was Jesus. John was understandably shaken by this. Wasn't Jesus in heaven with God? John wrote down what happened next, and so we're going to be in Revelation chapter 1, verse 17. When I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead person. But he put his right hand on me and said, "Don't be afraid. I am the first, the last, and the living one. I died, but now I'm alive forever. And I have the keys to death and the world of the dead." Jesus told John to write down what he was about to see and what was about to happen. And write down everything he saw. God was going to give John a vision of things that were to take place in the future. He wanted John to write them down to share it with others too, so they could believe. John watched amazed as God showed him many things that were coming. Some were wonderful, some were terrible, and some were mysterious. After the vision ended, John began his letter to several of the churches. In fact, John's letter to the churches is the book of Revelation. John explained every strange and amazing thing he had seen. Some of it made him tremble. Some of it wouldn't make sense until a later time, but the last part of the vision was incredible. God had shown John how the story will turn out after everyone who believes in Jesus dies. His story is something that's incredible. Carefully, John recalled the incredible things he had seen. I'm going to share some of them with you right now. It's tricky because words can't really describe what God's plan is for the earth and for us. It's kind of like a picture, a sneak peek of what we can see and what we can imagine until we get to see for ourselves how real and breathtaking everything will be. John started out like this. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared, and so had the sea. He might have remembered what Jesus had said right before he died. There are many rooms in my Father's house. I wouldn't tell you this unless it was true. I'm going to prepare a place for each of you. After I've done this, I will come back and take you with me. Then we will be together. John focused on the next scene from this vision. He saw a great white throne, and a voice spoke from the throne. Listen to what the voice said. I heard a voice shout from the throne, God's home is now with his people. He will live with them, and they will be his own. Yes, God will make his home among his people. He will wipe all tears from their eyes, and there will be no more death, suffering, crying, or pain. These things of the past are gone forever. When we are with God forever, there will be no more death, there will be no more sadness, there will be no more crying, no more pain. Isn't that incredible? Everything is going to be made right. Something else stood out to John in his vision. The light. There was so much light, and yet there was no sun or moon. Check this out. And the city did not need the sun or the moon. The glory of God was shining on it, and the Lamb, that is Jesus, was its lamp. And it isn't just full of light either. It's beautiful. And it has peaceful. Not only does God's plan involve beauty, but it also involves peace. Listen to how John describes this place. The angel showed me a river that was crystal clear, and its waters gave life. The river came from the throne where God and the Lamb were seated. Then it flowed down the middle of the city's main street. On each side of the river are trees that grow a different kind of fruit each month of the year. The fruit gives life, and the leaves are used as medicine to heal the other nations. The visions were incredible, and it wasn't over yet. John also saw people. He wrote, God's curse will no longer be on the people of that city. He and the Lamb will be seated there on their thrones, and its people will worship God, and will see him face to face. God's name will be written on their foreheads of the people. After 22 chapters describing the vision God gave him, John closed his letter. This is the last words of the Bible. I pray that the Lord Jesus will be kind to all of you. John didn't know exactly when the things God had shown him will take place. And neither do we. It's kind of like a puzzle. We have some pieces so we can kind of get an idea of what it will be like, but we can't put it all together yet. But that's because we don't have all the pieces yet. The story isn't finished. We can see a hint of what's coming. Because of what we've seen and heard, we can be certain of this. In the end, God will make things right for those who trust in him. Following Jesus will turn out greater than you can imagine. Let's go ahead and talk to God together now. Will you close your eyes and bow your head and pray with me? Dear God, thank you for allowing us to be a part of your big story. Because of what you've already shown us and because of what you showed John, we know that following you will turn out even greater than we can imagine. Thank you for this reminder that you are always in control. Please help us to remember that and to choose to trust you no matter what. We love you and we pray these things in your son named Jesus. Amen. Honestly, it's difficult for us to imagine what heaven will be like. There's a lot we just don't know. But it helps to focus on what we do know. We know that God made us. We know that God loves us. We know that God's been writing the big story since time began. We know that when God made people, God wanted to have a relationship with us. But we messed that up. Still, God always had a plan. God revealed the plan through generations of people. And when the time was right, God sent Jesus, God's Son, to be our Savior. Now, we have an amazing promise that anyone who puts their faith in Jesus will have a relationship with God that never ends. We'll experience life that lasts forever, with no more pain or death. We'll be fully alive with God in a way we can only imagine here on earth. Following Jesus will turn out greater than you can imagine. When you're worried about the future, or maybe someone you love gets really sick or dies, you can still live with confidence and joy in this life. You can have faith that God's plan is good and God's love for us will last forever. Things in this world often are broken. There's hurt and pain that we will have to face, but that's because the story isn't finished yet. Things aren't yet as they should be. But one day, they will. Thank you for listening. I look forward to seeing you.
Hello, everybody. I'm Erica, and welcome to my Steam Lab. I've got something extra special to show you today, and I have faith that it will be my coolest discovery yet. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. And what I can see is this awesome telescope! Ooh. Everything!
Wow.
I am super excited for what we'll be able to see through this telescope. Stars, planets, galaxies, satellites, space exploring cats?
Well, maybe not the cats.
There's a skylight in the lab.
So,
I can see all the cool stuff from right here. I just have to finish focusing the telescope. Okay, while I focus on the telescope, why don't you guys focus on the awesome Bible story today? It's out of this world.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Revelation, Chapter 21, verses 3 to 5.
John squinted against the blinding glare of the afternoon sun. Just a short distance away, frothy waves crashed against craggy rocks and foamed over white sands. This island of Patmos was isolated and rocky, but the view was stunning, surrounded by brilliant blue sea and sky.
Most beautiful prison on Earth.
Though he wasn't chained up, John was in jail, Roman emperor, who was unable to make John stop preaching about Jesus, had exiled him to this prison colony where many prisoners worked in the mines. There was no way off the island, so John was now very old, living out his final years on the island of Patmos with a handful of criminals.
I can share the story of Jesus with them too.
John settled into a shallow cave on shore to take shelter from the heat. He closed his eyes.
I've seen so much.
John had lived longer than any of the other of Jesus' disciples. He had watched the early church grow while the story of Jesus spread fast and bright as wildfire. But he had also seen terrible things happen to those who believed in Jesus. In fact, many people died just for talking about Jesus.
We saw everything Jesus did. We can believe he'll be with us forever, even through death.
Despite the threats and persecution, more people than ever were following Jesus. God's story was traveling from one end of the world to the other, just like Jesus said it would.
I wonder why I've been allowed to live this long.
In the cool of the shallow cave, John began to relax.
His head was nodding.
Until a voice like a trumpet sounded behind him.
Write on a scroll what you see.
John blinked. Was he awake or dreaming?
Wait, what? I don't see. Oh.
Turning, John saw Jesus himself, his eyes blazing with intensity.
Do not be afraid. I was dead, but look. I am alive forever and ever. Write about what is happening now and what will happen later.
John's mind worked quickly, trying to grasp what was happening. It appeared that God was trying to show him a picture of things that would happen in the future, and he wanted John to write them down and show them to others so that they could believe too.
Yes, Lord. Do you mind if I grab a scroll? Oh, and a quill. I don't want to forget anything.
John watched, amazed, as God showed him many things that were coming. Some were wonderful. Some were terrible. Some were mysterious. After the vision ended, John began a letter to several of the new churches.
I, John, am writing this. I am a friend who suffers like you. As members of Jesus' royal family, we can put up with anything that happens to us.
John explained every strange and amazing thing he had seen. Some of it made him tremble. Others wouldn't make sense until the right time had come. But the last part of his vision.
That's the very best part. I can't wait to write all about it.
God had shown John how the whole story will turn out for everyone who believes in Jesus. Carefully, he recalled all the incredible things he'd seen.
How am I going to do this? I mean, there's no way that words can capture it, but I have to try. It's just a picture until they get to see for themselves how real and breathtaking it will be. I saw a new heaven and a new earth.
John remembered the words that Jesus had spoken while he was on earth, right before his death and return to life.
There are many rooms in my Father's house. I am going there to prepare a place for you. If I go and do that, I will come back, and I will take you to be with me. Then you will also be where I am.
That's what I saw. It's the special place Jesus is making for each one of us, a place where we will never be apart from God.
John recalled the next scene from his vision. He saw a great white throne.
I heard a loud voice from the throne. It said, "Now God makes his home with people. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or sadness. There will be no more crying or pain."
John paused as he stared in wonder at what he had just written down.
All of these terrible things we've seen. People sick and hurt, being mocked and put in jail. All of it will be made right.
Something else stood out to John.
Light. There was so much light. The city does not need the sun or moon to shine on it. God's glory is its light, and the Lamb, Jesus, is its lamp. Its gates will never be shut because there will be no night there.
The place John had seen wasn't just filled with light. It was beautiful, too.
Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life. It was as clear as crystal. It flowed from the throne of God and of the Lamb. It flowed down the middle of the city's main street. On each side of the river stood the tree of life. Its fruit was ripe every month. The leaves of the tree bring healing to the nations.
Once again, John lifted his pen from the page. It just seemed impossible to share the real glory of what he had seen with tiny black marks on a scroll. He tried again.
God's servants will serve him. They will see his face.
John felt himself grinning. He could say one thing for sure, no one would be bored. He and every other person who believes in God would finally be able to live out what they were created to do, fully and completely, with no sin or frustration or weariness to get in the way.
May the grace of the Lord Jesus be with God's people. Amen.
Now, John didn't know exactly when the things God had shown him would take place, and neither do we. But from what we've seen and heard, we know one thing for certain. In the end, God will make everything right for those who trust in him.
Whoa! Would you look at that? That doesn't look like cheese at all! I love getting a glimpse of things I'm not used to seeing every day. Like today's story, we got a little glimpse of what the future could be like. When Jesus was on earth, he said if anyone puts their faith in him, they'll have a relationship with God that will last forever. That means we can be a part of God's big story, a story that never ends. Now, I don't know what you imagine when you think about heaven. Maybe it's clouds and harps and angels flying around. Maybe what you imagine is exactly right. Though there's a lot about the future we don't understand, it's exciting to think about the things we do know. When we believe in Jesus, we can look forward to a time when there will be no more pain, no more sadness. Everything will be made new. We will be fully alive with God in a way we can't even imagine. That's the one thing to remember today. Following Jesus will turn out greater than you can imagine. Having a glimpse at the future can give us hope here in the present. When we're worried about something or someone, or when we're sad or in pain, we know the bad things won't last forever. God has a future plan for us that we can truly focus on. Speaking of, let's see what this thing is focused on now.
I don't believe it! Space cats!
Oh. Gotcha! Thanks for hanging with me in the lab, and keep focusing on the important stuff. See you later!